As a JNU alumnus, I want to say that I am very proud of the way in which my alma mater has stood up against the kind of attack. Freedom of thought, freedom of expression. And this is not the first time that JNU has resisted in this way. I was in JNU during the emergency. I had joined just around that time. And I remember this was a time when students were, there was a particular student leader, Ravi Polkaista, who had protested against police presence on campus, police presence to guard the Prime Minister's daughter-in-law, who was at that time Manika Gandhi, was a student of JNU, and she would come to class with her armed bodyguards. So there was a protest, a spontaneous protest against the presence of police on campus. And 2 days after this meeting, at which Prabir had spoken very articulately, he was picked up on the road next to JNU in a white ambassador, and for the rest of the emergency, for something like 10 months, he disappeared from view. Later he came out and he had been in custody. But through those dark times when student organizations were banned, teachers, Januka also more or less came to a standstill, but people continued to meet, people continued to discuss, and somehow the values that the university stood for were kept alive. And it is because those values were kept alive that today we see this resistance in JNU. So I'm very proud of being from JNU, and I'm also very proud of belonging to CHIS, because CHIS is another institution where we have preserved these values, and we need to preserve them, we need to hold on to them. We do not outsource our nationalism to anybody. Nobody is a fool. We all know what it means to be Indian, a country with so many languages, so many different communities, different tribes, different castes, so many differences, yet we are one nation, and we will preserve the nation that we believe in, and we will not allow anybody to destroy it. And we have to preserve also the integrity of this institution, the integrity of all academic institutions across the country. This is a very difficult time. We need to be talking to each other. We need to be dialoguing. I know that some of our elders, to the youth I have this to say, that some of the elders have set very poor examples when they, kind of speak in monochromous tones that Bharat Mata ka apman hum sahen nahi karenge. We all believe in India, we all believe in the integrity of the country, and we will do it our own way, and we will preserve this nation, we will preserve our plurality, and we will survive these dark times.